Hello guys, I am Aloy Andaluz and this is 3ds Max News for the month of July. We will start very strong. We have 3ds Max Indie roll out worldwide. 3ds Max Indie starts like an initiative 1 year ago and it starts on a very selected countries to see how it goes. People was not sure if it will go through and actually they announced that August 7th, 3ds Max Indie will be available to much more countries, making a really viable option. So as you can see, it's not totally worldwide. What Chip Weatherman says is that by his understanding, this is the first batch of new countries. New countries will be added soon. So if your country is not on the list, maybe very soon will be. But what is 3ds Max Indie? A lot of people are confused. 3ds Max Indie is exactly the same 3ds Max that you had. It's not like Nuke or the Houdini that you have a lot of limitations. There are no limitations, no render size limitations, no plugin limitations, no scripts, no limited tools, no file format limitations. It's the same 3ds Max, it's just cheaper. 3ds Max Indie is $250 a year in USA, plus taxes. Your gross revenue needs to be under $100,000 a year, and you are limited to one license per user and a studio. These prices are based on USA and Canada, so in Europe and different countries can have some differences. My friend Changso Eun announced Render Stack will be available very soon, maybe when this video is out will be already available. It's a render pass manager for 3ds Max. You can control procedurally everything, cameras, resolution, frame range, object visibility, materials, object properties, layer properties, render parameters, and much more. You can use it not only for rendering managing, but also for a scene managing and organization. For example, you can turn all Turbo Smooth off on multiple objects with one single click, for example. If you are used to state sets in 3ds Max, imagine being state sets, way more powerful, way more possibilities. Cool thing, will be quite affordable and will be free for non-commercial use. So, pretty awesome option. I have been using it on beta. It's amazing. I think that will be a very popular tool. The Form Animation Tool is a new plugin for the Form Dynamics for 3ds Max. It's aimed for real-time cloth in 3ds Max. They say to be similar or superior quality to 3ds Max cloth, but 10 to 100 times faster. Basically because the physics engine is written in C++ and CUDA. So multi-core CPU, multi-thread GPU, to achieve exceptional performance and scalability, mesh collisions, accurate collisions with animated characters, multi-layered, animated characters can wear multi-layer cloth, realistic friction. It's available as a beta and you can check it out on theformdynamics.com. Vertex Color Editor is a new script by Joker Martini. It's basically to apply different vertex colors based on different conditions. You can apply vertex color per object, per vertex, or per element on different ranges of X, Y, Z, and configurations. It costs $3 on jokermartini.com. Martin Coben, now that we had time with this COVID situation, rendered something that he did in 3ds Max 2019 using the fluids in Max. There are a lot of people that they don't know yet that Max has a very good solver for fluids based on Bifrost or what it was before Nayad. As you can see, it's really good quality. This, no plugins here, it's 3ds Max alone, the solver that comes with 3ds Max. Really amazing, it creates very nice foam, render with Arnold, and yeah, you can check it out. It has a very complete walkthrough how he create all the scene environment and how different tips and tricks that he used on the solver to adjust different values. And yeah, you can do this in 3ds Max without plugins. Talking about visual effects and 3ds Max, don't miss out Iron Harvest. It's a DSL punk real-time strategy game and we have a new cinematic showcasing the game done by Capsule Studio. And because Ansem Bonseher, a very active member on 3ds Max, Tyflow, Thinking Particles community, worked on it, we know that they use a lot 3ds Max, Tyflow for the effects, Fume Effects and Phoenix FD for all the smoke that you can see that there are a lot of explosions and stuff on this cinematic, and V-Ray for rendering, astonishing work. Posture is a new 3ds Max script. allow the user to save multiple positions of unlimited objects, data can be stored globally or locally, and it's free, you can get it on GitHub. The EV Generator G-Tool has been updated to 0.75. It adds support for 3ds Max 2021, it's multi-threaded, you can create multiple plans in the same session, new leaf algorithm, custom leaf mesh support, and more. Now there is a suggested donation amount of $15, previous versions are still totally free. Verge 3D has been updated to 3.3, it's the artist-friendly toolkit for 3D interactive web application. It has multiple speed boosts, you can save different file formats, write on HTML5 canvas, use as texture on a model, but the quite important thing on this version is that adds support for 3ds Max OSL shaders in the web browser. The second issue of the architectural visualization magazine 3D Disciple is out now. 29 artists and studios cover, over 120 pages with multiple tutorials, projects cover from start to finish, you have covering BIM models, preparation to import in 3ds Max, export to Chaos Group, Lavina and Unreal Engine. You can get as well all the 3ds Max projects files associated to these tutorials. And as well, you have multiple interviews with Ion Gro from Chaos Group. Really interesting magazine if you like 3ds Max, really focused in ArchViz. Bifrost 2.1 for Maya has been released, and yeah, I know, it's for Maya, but in 3ds Max Bifrost will come at some point. You can join the beta of 3ds Max and see what we have right now there, but it's interesting to follow up what's happening in Maya because at some point we will have it in 3ds Max. And they add point cloud lookups, nearest neighbor search, raycasting, realizing geometry queries, you can now create compounds including collision deformers and attribute transfers, new icons, visual numbers over nodes for better reading of nodes, improvements on write read on multiple outputs, aero and particle graph has been simplified, npm sun snow has been updated with new ports and shortcuts, you can check it out on Aria. Thinking particles has been updated, drop 9 service pack 2, it has several bug fixes, the U-deflector now accepts particles as an input, so you can accept multiple nodes, not only one, and the most important for me is TP data channels. It's a material that allows you to access any data channel in thinking particles. So right now you can drive anything, OSL or any material procedurally using TP, it's super powerful. And finally, thank you, Sivas. As well, Final Render received a new service pack number 2. It has instancing improvements, Final Render light material improvements, new render elements, and multiple things that you can check out on Sivas webpage. During July, we had the 3ds Max webinar. It's available right now for all the people that was not able to attend. It's over 2 hours of a lot of information. All the news in 3ds Max 2021.1. All improvements on Viewport. You have Sab Anderson talking a lot about improvements on Viewport, also about his things and old technology. Quite cool. Improvements on render to textures, improvements on modeling side. Logan Foster talked about the improvements on modeling that we had in Max with shift and drag. Right now you can shift and drag and move for extrusion, shift and scale down for insets, and the improvements that this has on the workflow when modeling. Check it out because it's quite important the difference that we are having in modeling in 3ds Max. And we had two talks about two different companies, really interesting. In one side, K6 Media Group, that they work with Disney, creating animated feature films. Really interesting how they create all the setups in 3ds Max using Shotgun to manage all the huge number of scenes that they had, different scripts that they created, combined with different tools in 3ds Max. And in the other side, we had the multidisciplinary consultancy firm, let's see if I say it well, Huar Lea, that they create ArchViz and also lighting studies about all buildings. Really interesting how they approach their shots and they use 3ds Max to create as possible visualizations of the real lighting environments. At the end, you can see as well different talks and seminars that Autodesk has prepared for the next 2 months. Interesting to have it on the list because there are some interesting things coming. And Tyflow as well, a lot of activity on Tyflow group on Facebook. A lot of creative new ways to create effects in an easy way in 3ds Max. People is more active than ever, even in summer, that normally it's a kind of relaxed month. In July, But a lot of cool stuff that we saw with all the tools that we had. We didn't have any new update, but Tyson appeared magically and he showed what he's working on, and it's new CUDA-enabled accelerated splines collisions, so we can expect. He's saying it's working a lot with CUDA, so we will see much more accelerated and fast things in TypeFlow very soon. Really exciting, a lot of cool things happening on the group, and the tool is evolving quite fast. And that's all for July, guys. Normally it's quiet month because people is in holidays, but we had quite a lot of news this month. Let me know below what is your favorite. And thank you so much to be here. If you like the videos, please subscribe to the channel. Please share it with your friends. Give me a comment. You know I love comments. And thank you a lot to all my Patreons. If you want to support me even more, consider to be a Patreon. Love it to do these videos, but it's a lot of effort to do them. And yeah, that's all, guys. See you soon.